Dear AWS, I know you have been really working since 2016. You have more than decades of experience. You are the world's largest cloud provider. You are really awesome in bringing out the latest cutting edge technology that really eases that and helps us to really reduce our workflow. You really allow us to really just make to focus on a business logic aspect. And you really essentially take away all the stress and all the worries that we really used to previously deal in 10 years ago. You really have a bunch of cool brands that we really admire, like Netflix, Twitter, Snapchat, Adobe, Tinder, HTC, etc. and other out there. We know that every services that you provide are specifically aimed to the developers out there, to the business, to the corporations that would really just help us to really to streamline our process and to really helps us to reduce our cost and help us to save us more every bit, every single hour and every single second. But today's topic is just about what I really want to say is that about I just want to share about what my learning experiences are, and I really want to explain that why learning AWS is so frustrating. This is not something about to the company. I'm not really just slamming to the AWS itself, by the way, but I just want to share what I've really just faced and what AWS, yes, you can do it, something about it. What I have really started out to, so if you have really new to this channel, just consider if you have not really known to what I'm really doing. So I have really a project called FaceMash that I have been really working on and since I'm really right now working with. So I really just wanted to go to and taste the flavor of the cloud services about how it is and how it is not. So previously I just had an experience with the Netlify and really knows and house of how the cPanel actually works. So to previously just go into demonstrating how difficult it is, I just want to give it a simple example of really just using a photo editor app. So let's say, for example, if you really want to edit a photo, whether you want to just change the background color, you just want to add a simple filter. What you will essentially do if you don't have any some sort of app is like the first step, you will just go on type in the Play Store like a photo editor, and you will just see one app, you will choose one based on which provide which offers much more features out there, and you just really kind of experiment according to base of your needs. But if you want to really develop a professional thing, which most of the mobile apps aren't really capable of, then you will really need something, a desktop application like Adobe Photoshop, which has hundreds of tools, which has the capability, and each tool has the capability of performing thousands of functions out there. That means you have a permutations and combinations of lakhs of things which you can really do from a single software out there. So obviously when things become, when you have so much of randomness, so much of the permutations and combinations, what you will do is essentially just type it out in the Google, like, you know, I just want to learn Photoshop, just Photoshop tutorials, and you will try to get something out there. And it depends upon you, whether how much deep you want to go, whether you want to just be a Photoshop guru, you can just be try to take it out there, or you just want to be something else, or you just want to really just light stuff editing, then you can just learn up to that. So earlier I had just worked with Netlify, and I really tell you, Netlify is superbly easy to deploy. Like, you just really need a couple of command and things, and it really does your work for you. But you know, due to really just but we are really now moving into the era of cloud computing and all that kind of thing, so I just really wanted to get the flavor of working with AWS because it is the world's largest cloud provider, and I'll be doing my startup in 2020, at the end of 2020 or 2021. So as a production level, I was really planning to do make something in a thoughtful mind, whether really I want to really make something in a production ready state, whether all my services, all my products, all my code base are really scalable from the day one itself. So I really wanted something which is redundant itself, which has the capability to serve my needs, and AWS or it was a perfect choice. Although the Azure is also there, and GCP, IBM Cloud, Alibaba, DigitalOcean, others are also there. But for this video, we are really specifically focused on the AWS itself. So when I really started to learn, I was the first time I just registered my account, and I just really saw that, you know, there were so many services out there, so much thing like, what should I learn? What should I just go on? Then I just saw something called EC2 databases, RDS, DynamoDB, DocumentDB, and then it was kind of making a sense to me, like, yo, ha, something was really kind of mapping in my brain that yes, I need to do something and all this kind of thing. But when I really just saw and just click it out, there was so many options that you have to really go on to the IAM roles, selected IAM roles, and each IAM role has its own sub IAM roles, and that sub IAM roles has even that you can just go on to customize level. Like, I'm really confused, man. Come on, why can't you really make thing much more easier for us, like for us developer? Okay, even though if you want to really just provide so much security, if you want to provide customization, why can't you have a really better learning sources? Now you might say, hey, why haven't you checked the re:Invent conference? Haven't you checked the AWS online talks? Yes, definitely have checked it. But as a beginner, how would I know like which one is beginner to advanced level thing on all that kind of thing? Which one should I watch first? Which is the most appropriate for me? Which one should I really go through in a step-by-step manner? You have just really like bluntly created a playlist, and I get no sense. Like, you have 3,000s of more videos, which is superbly awesome. I appreciate you for your efforts of what you are doing, but you haven't really sorted yet from the beginners to advanced, beginner to the enterprise level. I'm as a student who really wants to learn the AWS, it's really kind of getting frustrated. Like, you know, I just get up to the Udemy search for the DynamoDB course, and I just see that 16 hours of course just for learning a database, like how to operate and all that kind of thing. Even MongoDB was superbly easy than what I have really learned through it. You just really need to insert the credentials, you just need to submit the URI key, and you are really good to go. But no, in DynamoDB, first you create the IAM roles, you just kind of get the really just give it all the access. You just kind of really go to the subdomain, you really edit file into the JSON structure, then you really upload your all the Node.js, all the JavaScript project into the Lambda, then really just link the DynamoDB with the Lambda functions to in a certain cases, then you really specify an IAM role for that even itself, then you really just edit to the, like, it's such a ridiculous process. Like, even right now, even I'm confused about what should I really do about it. I just want to really ask, like, why don't you really just simplify the process? Now you might say that, hey, we have a thing called AWS Amplify. Now yes, you have that, but you know, it's still relevantly new, and it doesn't have that level of customization, number one. And I know the fact that you are offering such a customization is for the better, for the betterment, and the for more enhanced security for the business purpose, and the consumer's data privacy should be much more intact. The services should be get I get that. I get it, what you say. But why can't you really just make learning materials so feasible to us? Like, this is the thing, this is the product, this is the, to use this product, you really need to go through this. You know, as a beginner developer, no one likes to really read the document. No, I'm really bluntly like, you do really need to read the document at the proof of stage, but for as someone who is really learning the development, web development, Android or iOS in the first stage itself, and they want to really build their own first application using your services, then why don't you really just provide easy accessible tutorials? Like, and bunch of other things is like, in a nutshell, I just wanted to really ask you that please make it simplify for us. Please make your process and the reInvent conference playlist in such a way that we as a beginner would really get familiar easily with your services, and that could really just kind of help you to get more customers. I don't know, like, why should I really spend my whole time in just learning all that kind of thing, you know? And I have one thing that I have really realized, that mastering AWS is itself like mastering a programming language. The amount of time that you have really invested in learning the programming language is the same, and that will be the same itself to really learn the nuts and bolts of AWS, to really like to become an AWS ninja. So this was it, guys. I just want to really share you that why AWS is so frustrating and AWS is so complicating, but what you can do about it. Well, you can really search on topic as well. So I hope that you have really liked this video, and thanks till now that you have watched my video. If you have any question, queries, comment, suggestion, just leave down in the comment and I'll be happy to get back to you. So till then, stay connected, stay subscribed to my channel, and see you next time.